about quantum heat machines with trapped ions.
I want to thank the conference organizer to give me an opportunity to present our work in this conference. And I am from Department of Physics, IIT Roper. And the work is with my PhD supervisor, Dr. Ashoka Biswas. So IIT Roper is from India. It is specifically northern part of the India, a state called Punjab, where we have a region, Roopnagar, where my institute is located. So what is the motivation of studying this quantum heat engine? To study the quantum thermodynamics, one of the way to probe the subject is the study of quantum heat engine. It start with a work on 1959 with a three-level measure as a heat engine. And from that, the work on the domain of quantum heat engine to view the quantum topic of quantum thermodynamics is going on. And we find some striking papers on this particular field, like we can extract work from a single heat bath, which cannot be possible in classical domain, or we are demanding that we can outperform the classical Carnot bound by using the quantum property of the working substance or the heat bath. So in this motivation, I also try to propose a model which can be realizable in practical scenario. So for doing so, I just give a basic introduction that in quantum domain, we redefine the heat and work to like other than classical system. So heat is like a changing system where the occupation probability is changing, although the energy eigenstructure is fixed, and work in some process where the energy eigenstructure is changing, although the occupation probability is fixed. So with this basic definition, how we can implement different classical version of the heat cycle in quantum version. So we are basically concentrated on the Otto cycle. Why Otto cycle? Because the heat and work distinction is specific for each cycle. Like in isochoric branch, we are only exchanging heat with the thermal environment. And during the adiabatic process, we are only exchanging work. So for that, we are interested in Otto cycle. So implementing a quantum Otto cycle, what we require? We require a hot bath, we require a cold bath, and obviously we require a physical system. And what else? We have to properly implement that quantum isochoric branch and quantum adiabatic branch. So what is just quantum isochoric process? In this, in classical isochoric process, there is no work exchange, but heat can be exchanged with the thermal environment. At the end of the isochoric process, the system is equilibrated with the thermal environment. In quantum isochoric process, similarly, the system is equilibrated with the thermal equilibrium at the end of the quantum isochoric process. In this process, the heat is exchanged with the thermal environment, or although there is no work done or by the system or on the system. Similarly, in quantum adiabatic process, it is although mainly different that it is very slow process, so that the system is remain on the initial eigenstate. And so the occupation probability, although not changing, but due to change in the energy eigenstructure, system is doing some amount of work, or work is doing on the system, but no heat is exchanging. So what is the problem? The problem is implementing proper quantum adiabatic process, because in adiabatic sense that there should be no heat exchange with the system and with the environment. But to implement that quantum heat engine in practical scenario, we cannot switch off the interaction with the thermal bath and the system, because the thermal bath or the thermal environment is always there. We cannot switch it off according to our need. So we have to bypass this thing to implement this more physical, practical heat engine. So what is the proposal of us? We are proposing that we can implement quantum heat engine with always on bath condition. We are never switch off the system interaction with the thermal bath. Still, we can implement our quantum heat engine. So how we do that? For doing so, we are proposing first model that we are considering a single trap ion. The ion is considering in Lambdic limit. So the number of excitation in the motional state is very small, so that it can be considered a two-level system. So we are taking the advantage of the 2 degrees of freedom of the ion. The working substance is defined internal state of the ion, and the cold bath of the engine is defined the motional state of the ion. And the what is the hot bath? Hot bath is the thermal environment of the ion. So this is the Hamiltonian, where G is the representing coupling between the internal state, and B is the magnetic field by which we can control our engine, and H photonic is representing the total energy or the vibrational mode, where omega is the trap frequency, and A dagger is the annihilation creation operator. And K is the coupling between internal state and motional state of the ion, or we are considering K very small. So with this model, how we implement quantum auto engine, the step 1 to 2 is a isochoric heating process. So we fix the our magnetic field at a certain value. We allow the our system, the internal state of the ion, is interact with the thermal environment. The cold bath, which is vibrational mode, is also in the present in the model. So both the internal state and the motional state is thermalized with the thermal environment at the end of the process. So we can calculate the what is the occupation probability of the system after the thermalization. And we are assuming that the system is initially preparing in the ground state, so we can calculate how much heat is transferred between thermal environment to the system. The second step is a adiabatic process. The condition is that there should be no heat exchange. But we are not proposing that we are switched off the thermal environment and also the cold bath is there. So how we implement this proper quantum adiabatic process? Basically, we change the magnetic field from a certain value to a certain lower value VL, so that there is a no heat exchange, but the system can perform the work, and we can calculate the work by using this definition, where this is the system eigenvalue changing, and this is the fixed occupation probability. That the question is that, is this really is adiabatic sense, because there is a thermal environment. We have solved the joint dynamics of the system for known state, and we find that the occupation probability in the system is almost remaining constant for the linear variation of the magnetic field. So we can say that safely that although the thermal environment is there, but due to managing our time scale of the thermal adiabatic process, there is a no heat exchange. We are again, this is the proposal, is that the adiabatic time scale should be small enough of the respect to the bath decay scale. So for example, omega of a single trap ion can be order of 10 megahertz. So tau, which is the adiabatic time scale, can be order of 0.5 microsecond, whereas the decay rate of the system is few second and decay rate of the phonon mode is few milliseconds. So obviously the adiabatic time scale is much smaller than the decay rate of the system or phonon. So we can implement our adiabatic process in that sense. So next cycle 3 to 4 is a isochoric cooling process, but our cold bath is there in our model. So how we use our model? Here we propose a projective measurement on the internal state of the ion, and we will take for this particular projective measurement state, which is effectively projected the system in its internal ground state. If it is projected on the ground state, then the occupation probability is decreasing, system is releasing some amount of heat, and due to the instantaneous projective measurement, the bath and the system is decoupling, and we are demanding that this amount of rejected heat will be taken by this phononic mode. Although it has a finite heat capacity, because we are considering only 2 modes, but at that moment it is acting like a cold bath. So we can calculate obviously what will be the heat release during this projective measurement, after the projective measurement step. And finally, this is 4 to 1 is again adiabatic compression step. So for that we changing the magnetic field adiabatically from to initial value, and similarly there is a no heat exchange, and work can be done by the on the system. So it is a initialization process, and the cycle is complete. Now question is that the vibrational mode have a finite heat capacity. Can it be used for the next cycle? Yes, but again 1 to 2, the joint system phonon will be thermalized with the thermal environment, so the phonon mode can be again used as a cold bath for the next cycle. So the efficiency of our proposed model is similar to the standard equation, but here we use one cost of the projective measurement, that we are projecting the system in its internal state. So if we take this projective measurement cost, our efficiency will be modified, and we will gain the efficiency much lower than the actual efficiency without measurement cost. Now the question is that our model normally valid for a single LAN, because it is probabilistic case that 50% case it can be projected on the excited state also. So how we can overcome this situation? For that, we are proposing that if it is projected on the ground state, we'll do nothing. But if it is projected on the excited state, we give a pi pulse to make it ground state. So this also have some cost, and we can calculate that, include that cost. So first part is just a heating part, which is due to projected on the excited state, and this is the work cost to reverse things from excited state to ground state, which will basically again reduce our achievable efficiency, but it will learn for many cycle. Our second proposal is based on two interacting trap ion, that we are considering similar model like previous, but here we have two atom, and there is a coupling between the internal state. We are considering the system is the joint internal state of the ion, and the common vibrational mode act like a cold bath. And we have four possible measurement bases. Now we are not restricted to only observing the heat engine phenomena. We'll project our system each in every possible projected on the basis. And now we find that if we projected on the ground state, we obviously get some heat engine phenomena, but condition is that it is restricted on some particular region. So above that region, it will not operate like an engine. And if we project this our system to excited state, then we basically get a refrigerator. And similarly, but for particular this E3 state, we are getting refrigerator phenomena, but it is also restricted by parameter domain. So our model can be used as a heat engine or refrigerator depending on the choice of our measurement basis. So finally, our third model is that we are taking three trapped ion, so that we are trying to see that how, what is the effect of the third ion on the working sustenance of the two ion. This is our model. So this is the auxiliary system which is connecting with our system, that is two trap ion. And we are trying to find how the coupling with this auxiliary system with the system is affecting our engine performance. And we are also try to find what is, because if you see that Hamiltonian of the working sustenance, you will find that there is a system, if you change the eigenvalue, there is a critical point where we have not a predefined ground state. So what will be the system behave at that particular critical point? And we find that the system, we can enhance the efficiency of the engine if we project our system in the ground state and we maintain at the critical point. So I just skip this point. So basically, our model is exciting model, because it can be, we are hope that it can be implemented in laboratory, and we do not require specifically distinguish cold bath. Our measurement process and can be act like a cold bath, and due to always on bath interaction with the thermal environment of the system, it can be implemented easily in laboratory. So we hope that it is can be implemented in laboratory in future. So thanks for my question.
Very well, thank you. We have a couple of minutes for questions.